Well, Cambridge Mineral Resources is a privately owned junior mining exploration and development company founded in 1992. Well, its main focus is the Iberian Pyrite Belt in southern Spain, where it's investigating the Masa Valverde copper-zinc deposit near Huelva in conjunction with a major mining and commodity trading group. It's also evaluating a number of other mining projects in Andalusia. Well, Mark Slater is the chief executive. I hope I got all the pronunciations correct in my intro there, Mark. But before we talk about your projects with the unpronounceable names. There are moves afoot to take you from private to AIM listed status. Is this the right time?
We believe so as a board. We've been looking at doing this for the last few months, and the commodity prices are depressed, as we all know. But I think we're pretty close to the bottom now, and I can't see them going too much lower. It is planned for a few months from now anyway. We had hoped to do it later this year, but looking at the markets, we've decided to just hold off a little bit longer.
Okay, I might be stating the obvious, but is the aim of going on AIM to tap an investor base who will help with these projects?
Well, we think that there's an opportunity there for potential investors and our existing shareholders to support the business and help the business grow forward, and realistically to take advantage of some very good opportunities in Andalusia at the moment.
Tell me about those good opportunities.
Well, as you know, with the project we have at Masa Valverde, we're JV'd with Glencore, and unfortunately Glencore are going through a bit of a difficult time at the moment, as most people have seen. But that in itself presents opportunities. We work very, very well with Glencore, and to be fair, they've worked very well with us. They're very good partners to have, and we've been very pleased with the project. And the drilling so far has shown that the resource down there is a little bit better than expected, and one or two other pleasant surprises. So there's opportunities there that if the company is properly structured and properly funded, has a real future.
Talk to me about the resource. Can you tell me about the grades and the amount that's possibly there?
I believe the early estimations are around about 100 million tonnes. The grades are quite good. They're not spectacular, not stellar as you would get in some, but they're quite good. You're looking at around about 7% zinc copper. It is the zinc that I believe our partners have their eyes on, and I think rightly so. There's three mining operations that are coming to end of life within the next 5 years that are zinc producers. So of course in 5 years' time, the zinc supply will start to get a lot lower, and therefore a new zinc operation coming on stream at about that time seems like a good business sense and good business planning.
So how did you come across these assets and these projects, and how far are you, how involved are you with them in terms of, you know, permits and licenses and ownership?
CMR has had a bit of the history some years ago. Back in 2009 we delisted because we thought it was the right time to take a step back and look at restructuring the business. I think personally the company was too thinly spread with operations in different parts of the globe. And coming out of that restructuring, was to get rid of some of the other operations and just focus solely on Andalusia. One, it's in the EU. It's very close to get to, looks like 2 hours from Luton, whereas operations in South America are much more challenging to get and therefore manage a lot closer. So we've focused solely in Andalusia. I mean, we've managed to develop some very good working relationships with the authorities, who have been very pro-business. I mean, the Spanish authorities are really helping businesses now, and it's a good place to work. And the other mining operations there, there's a lot, it's a pyrite belt, there's a lot of operations there. Rio Tinto have recently got permission to get back started again. So it's an exciting place at an exciting time. So we've managed to develop these relationships. We've managed to get full option agreements on a number of mining concessions that are owned by a Spanish family for well over 100 years. And we've managed to develop that relationship with them, and we're now working, if you like, with them to exploit some of the operations that, or some of the mining concessions that they have in the region. So that's been good. And obviously, Masa Valverde was a concession that we had some years ago, but again, back in 2009, we didn't continue paying the licenses and taxes. So we managed to get it, you know, we managed to get the license back and move forward with it.
How confident are you that Andalusia will provide company-making opportunities?
Oh, very much so. 100%, 110%. The Andalusian authorities and the Spanish authorities have been extremely helpful. They are very keen to bring, obviously, employment, taxes to the region, and they're working very closely with us. And obviously, they have issues regarding environmental impacts, etc., and they are strict on that, but rightly so. And I think that we can work with that, and it's a good working environment.
So which project is Glencore involved with, and is that relationship tight?
Absolutely, yeah. Masa Valverde is one we work with Glencore with. We work well with Glencore. We go to the monthly meetings there. The team on the ground, they're very unassuming chaps, very, but so professional. I mean, really professional, and we're working well there. Their plans for this project, we're now well into 2017. I've seen the forward plans, I've seen the cash flow forecasts, I've seen obviously the budgets, etc. And they're very open with all the information that's gained. We work well.
Now, speaking about teams, let's have a look at the board, because people are probably more important than the potential of an asset and an opportunity. So what is the board's collective strength?
The board will change at IPA or shortly before. The strength of the board at this point in time was to take the business from where it was to where it is. And I think in all businesses, people have different strengths, and they can develop those strengths within the business and help to move that business forward. And as we move more into an operational mode, and as we move more into the technical side of the business, which is more required now and very, very shortly, then the board will change and more technically astute directors will go on the board. I may continue, who knows, whether the shareholders and the rest of the board want me, but it's having the right team in the right place at the right time to do the job. And I think the board on standby are absolutely first class. All mining expertise, all experienced in listed companies, both UK and internationally. The existing board has done, I believe, a sterling job in pulling the business through difficult times and focusing it solely on a single strategy that we now have.
So some investors will be wanting to know, are you revenue generating now, or when do you hope to become revenue generating?
The business could, obviously Masa Valverde is geared to be in production around about 2020, 2021. The other concessions could be brought into production a lot sooner, 3 to 4 years. So we could be revenue producing, shall we say, within that time. But in this industry, with these multinationals and these giants out there, who knows what's around the corner?
Mark Slater, Chief Executive of Cambridge Mineral Resources, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
No problem, and thank you for seeing me.
You're welcome.